Morning, everyone. So this is my final day of being here, and welcome to Back to the High School special. So today I'm just doing two more speeches for two more grade 8 classes. And like I said earlier in the other video, I'm very glad to be back here to do presentations for the newer students that have joined Wellington recently. And you could tell I'm not wearing my Wellington t-shirt. Well, first of all, it's in the wash, but I'm very glad to actually find my dry grad t-shirt. So I'm gonna, I wore it today just to throw back my memories a little more again. And I also wanna share a bit of some more memories, of course, of the outside areas a bit. Because I remember, there's another huge memory I remember just for when I graduated from high school, which is the front of the building, the brand new look of the front side of the building. I'll show it to you in just a few seconds. So this front area here, of course, the inside as well. And of course the outside, we had a grand opening event just out there. And we had a whole bunch of chairs set up too, and we had people speaking on behalf of the new this new school design, which was the recent renovation, of course, of Wellington Secondary School, which was on May 31st, 2016. And it's still a great school at this day, even though I'm not attending the school anymore. But I'm very glad, like I said, I've always been happy to be back because I love attending the school through my whole entire school years. So yeah, just wish me luck again one more time, and I will see you guys all in a little while.
Oi, good morning. Difficulties with
Uplands Spark Elementary School. Were there any students, raise your hand if you went to Uplands? Oh, that's a lot of people this time. Yes. It was a great school. I definitely have to agree. Uplands, I was there for my whole entire year, kindergarten to grade 7. And kindergarten, when I, just before I started kindergarten, I was nervous because of the new classroom and especially the new teachers because I've never met them all yet. And I wasn't used to meeting new teachers yet back then. So I was absolutely nervous. But kindergarten was easy. It wasn't tricky for me. But when I started grade 1, I had lots of learning problems as well as behavior issues, especially at recess time. Like, you know, you'll probably catch a lot of moments before if you remember in elementary school where you see fights going on at recess. True enough, it's happened to me a lot. Not a lot in grade 1, but especially in grade 4. Grade 4 year was the worst school year ever for me because I got into so much trouble, and of course, going to the principal's office a lot for so many different things. Not just, I wouldn't say just the principal's office so much every time, but as well as talking to teachers, kind of like getting detention. But then my behavior did improve as well throughout grades 5 to 7, but it's not 100% though is how I am right now. So high school, I did go to this school, like Mr. Christian has said in the beginning, Wellington Secondary School. I've been here since when I was you guys' age, grade 8, and I really enjoyed being here at this school. So I'll start with grade 8 when I was you guys' age. The first day of high school, of course, was very different for me, and I was actually more nervous to start here than at Uplands for a few reasons. The first reason is, first of all, the building is very huge for me, so I thought I was never going to get used to high, like the whole building, knowing where I'm supposed to go for classes. I bet you guys would all feel that way too when you first started the school this school year. But then 2 weeks into my high school, and then also I should also explain first, I didn't expect a huge crowd of people in my first day of school. But do you know what? When you start a new chapter in your lives, the multiple times you meet friends, you meet 2 times more of the people that you met in your previous year. So elementary school, you would meet probably just a few bits of people. But then high school, you meet much more people, 2 times more people, because they're from different schools and they all connect to one big school, like this building. And then 2 weeks into my first year of high school, I made lots of new friends and also started to love going to school. Because I loved school, and I was never feeling jealous about hating school. Like, is there anybody that actually loves going to school, like learning, Ms. Victor? Oh, well, we're getting a good number. That's good. Yeah. Well, I am proud of you, because school is a good thing. Getting an education and having fun, especially at PE, which was my most favorite subject. Grade 11, we're just going to skip to grade 11, because grades 9 and 10 were very similar to grade 8 was. So grade 11, there was a big change. My biggest moment in my grade 11 year was when I decided, which was on my own actually, to change my life completely. Now I'm going to tell you guys a little story, and you're going to find it's a very serious story. So I was trying to go to sleep one night a couple of years ago. So I couldn't fall asleep, because for a good reason. Normally I would fall asleep just for no reason, but there was a reason this time why I couldn't fall asleep. So I was thinking about in my brain all the things I've done wrong over the years for several 5+ years, not just from here, but when I was at Uplands, trying to remember all the bad things I had that I've done to students. So then before I fell asleep, the one thing that I whispered into my mind was, the next morning when I come to school, I'm going to apologize to all my friends I've known for the things I've done wrong. So what I did was the next morning, woke up, head here, I went around to everybody around that I've seen, and I made a huge apology. And I was feeling emotional because I felt bad for the things that I've done wrong. And then it goes on to what I'm about to say here. Once my life changed completely, all my friends in high school started to become such amazing friends to me, just like now. Like if I was gonna hang around at lunchtime today and people can notice me, they're not gonna feel disappointed or be avoided. They're just gonna be excited because of how much I changed this world in the school. Grade 12 last year, it was the final year of high school. Absolutely was emotional because of thinking back from all the memories I had for 5 years here. But also a good memory was during the 2016 award ceremony from last year, I received something, it's called a School Spirit Award. They started making that award 2 years ago. And I actually got one in grade 11, but this was probably the best one I got because I got a couple different medals as well as certificates. And I did deserve it because of how much I changed my life and try to, show some school spirit. But the one thing that always gets me curious is who's going to get that this year? And the years on and the years on. It always gets me curious because I'm never here anymore. So I'll show you two pictures. The one on the left is me when I was your age, grade 8. And then the other one is my grade 12 picture. So what that's going to happen when you get to grade 12, you got to get ready to dress into the gown, be fancy, and get a good picture in. But I gotta be honest, I was trying not to smile, but I just needed to for my friends. So whoever raised your hand went to Rock City last year, you might remember this card. I remember when I first got this card, I noticed this envelope and I was like, I didn't think I would expect something this big. So then when I opened the envelope and got this card, I opened it and this is what I got. So it says, "Then step into the future with confidence and always be proud of who you are. Congratulations, best wishes from Rock City Elementary." And then it has all these student names on there, and even the teachers and even the principal, Mr. Young, when he was there, he actually wrote in this card, and I just couldn't stop reading it. It was really good, and I still have it in my place somewhere. But I'm never going to throw that away, and I always want to share that memory every time I present to schools. So now I'm going to share with you something. I call this a big step, and I have a good reason why I call it a big step. It's because, like I was talking about a few minutes ago when I won the 2016 School Spirit Award, well, there's a double to this. So if you might remember Mr. Mason from last school year, because he's retired now as a vice principal here. But he was not just a vice principal. He was also a teacher as well as a coach. Because he's been at Wellington for 26 years, and he's done so much to show school spirit to the school for so many different ways. And so they wanted to surprise him for his retirement to actually make an award out of this plaque here called the Tom Mason Bobcat Award. And they also wanted to award a grad student that did the same thing for Mr. Mason and for everybody else in the school. So it turned out I was the first student that actually won, and I'm going to show you a sample of what it looks like. So this is what it's like. It's actually in the hallway, just not far away from here. It has my first name and last name on it, Matthew Crassell, 2015-16. But all the other ones are empty because I'm the first student that won it last year. But I always get curious too of who's going to win it for all the other ones, because it's going to keep going on for a very long time, just to remember the times when Mr. Mason was here. And he was a great vice principal when I was here. So I'm going to show you actually a video now of when I actually won the award, because it was very emotional times.
Listening to me for our final award for tonight. This is an award presented for the first time in 2016. This award goes to a school to much like this makes and represent the spirit of Wellington. Thank you.
pretty cool, eh? Yeah, it was a big surprise, especially because, first of all, because of Mr. Mason's retirement surprise, as well as a grad for myself surprise. So then once, after the ceremony, I was very disappointed to leave all my awesome friends I've known for a very long time, for 5+ years. It was absolutely emotional times, but I still feel emotional now. Not just coming in back to the building to see what it's like when I'm not here attending, but also my friends that have gone to a new chapter in their lives. So I'll show you two of them. So the one on the left is my best friend I met actually on my grade 8 orientation. Known him for 6 years, we're still best friends at this day. And he comes over to visit with me quite often, every so often. Then the other is, his name's Daniel Goodman, by the way. And then one, the other one, his name's Dave Northway. I met him a bit in grade 8, but didn't really hung around talking to him until grade 9. And yeah, they're really good friends of mine. But the one question I want to ask is, how can you show school spirit to this place? Just to think into your own mind. Like, there's several ways you can show school spirit. Like, but you guys can all think about it into your own mind, because it may take you time to think about it. So, Mr. Christian, do we have time for questions? The bell went.
We do have to make it on the bell because we're recording currently.
Okay.
It's not 9:53. Okay.
Yeah. So, is there anybody that has any questions at all? Or? Anybody? Oh, yeah.
I'm a teacher. So, I'm my first year here that I've been at fall school. So, anybody can really be involved in school. So, how proud do you feel that all your peers gave you standing ovation?
Oh, yeah.
Please disregard that bell. That was set from last week. Please disregard that bell.
But yeah, I was very supportive, not just for how much I show support, but as well as how anybody else can. Like teachers, and I always try to support teachers when I was in class, being quiet. Because you would always have to tell the class, can you guys be quiet, please? And whatever. Yeah, I've had those moments before where I always have to be quiet because I always had to listen. Anybody else? Yeah, Ms. McCurry?
I made it just in time. If you were to think back about your biggest struggle that you've had in school, something that was maybe really challenging for you to overcome, what would that have been in high school?
Here at this school?
Yeah.
Well, I have been bullied before. Not many times, but I've been bullied a lot, not just because of my disabilities, but I can't remember the reasons. But I definitely have caused trouble by being a little disrespectful, even in PE sometimes. But I still enjoy the subject. Like, I still would totally go back if I had to. But I think those are the only worst times I remember. In this school, otherwise elementary school goes with the worst. Thanks. Any students, are you sure? You don't have anything? Yep.
Did you ever expect to win any of the awards that you did?
Not in the grad ceremony, actually, no. I thought I was just going to be sitting down in the chair relaxing, I was falling asleep, but no. No. Actually, I didn't fall asleep, but I think I was surprised. Where you saw the video, that was actually right near the end of the grad ceremony. So it was kind of like a big surprise just before I finished. And then I knew I was going to get the school spirit award here at this school. I knew I was going to be. Not just because I won in grade 11, but also for how much I've done similar to grade 11, near the end of grade 11, in grade 12. Yeah, thanks. Anyone else? Don't be shy. I like his response. Yeah.
Were you in the band program?
Just in grade 8 I was. Actually, when I was taking band, I actually was in the grade 9 jazz band because I was playing guitar back then. I couldn't play any other instrument. But I had to stop because when I took the field trips, it made me miss too much of my classwork and I got too far behind. So after grade 8, I just stopped taking band and then focused just on my other subjects. But the band was fun. I wasn't really a huge jazz person, but it wasn't that bad. bad for a subject. I just couldn't take it anymore because of all my other subjects getting far behind. Thanks. Anyone else? No?
Anybody?
No?
So Matt, these guys are almost done in their first year of high school at four left. What advice in terms of, not necessarily the schoolwork part stuff, but in terms of getting involved and what those 4 years might be for, what advice might you have for them?
Well, my advice to all of these grades here is try to be a leader, especially in grade 12, but also sooner would be better. For the new grades that come to school the next several years, yeah, try to be a leader, because that's what I did, and it worked. And Mrs. Gertzen gave me that advice, actually, because I had her for PE 4 times in grades 8, 9, 11, 12. So I know that advice really well. Yeah, that's probably my only good advice I can think of, yeah. You sure you don't have any other questions? Just before I finish, I just want to show you my website, www.mmcrassell.wix.com/mysite. I have music. I've played music for 11 years. I've also had other speeches I've done in schools that I've done for 2 years, as well as good facts. And I've actually been in radio interviews as well last while too. But I also have good facts that people will find interesting about me. So yeah, I just want to make a big thank you. I'll pass it back to Mr. Christensen.
Presentation. I really hope you all enjoyed it so far, especially the other ones from the other day. I just have one more presentation to go in the last little few minutes, and I hope you enjoy that one. And I'm very glad, like I said earlier, I'm very glad to be back again, and I'm really enjoying it so far. So yeah, take care and enjoy the last presentation, and I'll hopefully see you all in a little while.
Just gonna do a quick introduction. This is Matthew Crassell. Any of you guys go to Rock City last year? You guys recognize Matt from last year? So he was a grade 12 student here last year. He's 5 years in Wellington. And during grade 12, he did his presentation down at Rock City, first time he'd ever done it. And then this year he's changed the presentation a little bit and gone to Rock City called Tai, and he came and saw Mr. McCray and I. Mr. McCray was his, what, grade 8, 9 teacher?
I also appeared here.
What did she teach you? What subject did she teach?
It was actually mathematics.
Oh,
our worst subject.
Oh, but not your worst teacher.
No. She was funny, though.
Good save, Matt. Good save.
So Matt's presentation, you see, is called My Autistic Life. He's kind of got two messages. He talks a little bit about growing up with autism. What's that like? And then the second part, just about being at high school, being involved. And he's got a couple of really neat stories to share with you about his experience here at Wellington. And questions at the end of it. So try to ask lots of questions so Mr. McCray doesn't have to ask that anymore. Right, Matt?
Yes.
Okay. No further ado, welcome Matt Crass.
Good morning. Doing good?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good to hear. Yeah, like Mr. Christensen said, my name is Matthew Crass. does my autistic life, from starting young life to previous, to current now. So before I do that, I want to just give you an overview of what autism is in general, because there might be some of you guys that don't remember what autism is. That's okay, because I can tell you now. Autism is a treatable neurological spectrum disorder, and it affects between 1 to 150 children, youth, and adults in BC alone. So that's almost people of all ages in British Columbia. Most people that have autism see things differently than others. That's the main reason why I got diagnosed with it, autism. And some people that have autism may have problems learning different subjects anywhere. And I have that same thing too, and I'm going to talk a little bit more about that in a little while. So at the beginning of my life, that's me as a newborn. I was born very recently on May 7th, 1998. Recently just turned 19. And it's good to be an adult now, grown up, and I live on my own too now as well. So I'm able to take care of myself. My preschool years, I started schooling in preschool. I went to the Child Development Center here in town. And then that was also starting to be that time where I met lots of new friends that I'd never met before. Told the teachers too. But also learning new things, especially like learning how to paint in art, as well as coloring, drawing, and stuff like that, pictures and coloring books and all, etc. And also trying to learn how to play properly. And I've had some not huge amount of trouble, but I had a lot of fun. You know, I remember looking through all the photo memories of me in preschool, and there was good times. And I was there in preschool for 2 years. So elementary school, anybody went to Uplands? Yeah, lots of, a few of you, that's good. Yeah, Uplands was my school I went to for elementary school, kindergarten to grade 7. And it was good times, but there was also some disappointing times as well where I got to a lot of trouble. But not in kindergarten when I started there. I was just a bit nervous. First of all, because of how big the classroom was. It wasn't super big, but I didn't expect to be in a classroom like that, as well as the teachers. They're all different. I never met these teachers besides in preschool. But in grade 1, I had lots of learning problems and behavior issues, even during recess especially. I had troubles where I would go to the principal's office sometimes during that time, but not often, but especially grade 4. Grade 4 was absolutely the worst year because I've been to the principal's office a lot, as well as not just the principal's office every time, but especially talking to the teachers, kind of getting the attention. But I can't remember the reasons why I got in trouble. I know I've done a lot of fighting in the past, especially during this time. But then my behavior did start to improve a bit more throughout grades 5 and 7, but not 100%, that's how I am now. But it was getting there. So high school, like Mr. Christian said in the beginning, I went to this school for 5 years, grades 8 to grade 12. I did enjoy the school a lot, but when I started here, I was very nervous, because when I was you guys' age, it was very different for me starting this school for a few reasons. The first reason is the building is a lot bigger than Uplands was, so I didn't know how I'm going to get to all my 4 different classes every semester, because I had to go around, because I didn't want to feel lost, because I hate feeling lost. But all of you guys don't like being lost anywhere, don't you? No. But then another reason is on my orientation day, when I started grade 8, I didn't expect a huge crowd of people. But then I understand why. The reason is, it's not just the people at the students at Uplands that go to Wellington. There's also kids from, you know, Coltai, Departure Bay, Rock City. They all connect to the school, calling it theater schools, which means we feed into Wellington. So then you connect to the school, but also you meet 2 times more of the people that you did that you met in elementary school. And then 2 weeks into my first year of high school, I made lots of new friends and I started to love going to school. And I still like school to this day if I was gonna still attend school, because school was fun. It wasn't disappointing because in elementary school I didn't like school much, but I especially like going to school when I was attending here. So we're gonna skip to grade 11 because grades 9 and 10 were similar to grade 8. So grade 11, there was a big moment where I changed my life completely. Now I'm gonna tell you guys a little story. 2 years ago, I was trying to go to sleep one night. I tried to fall asleep, but I couldn't for a good reason. Normally, when you try to fall asleep, but you can't, there's usually no reason. But there was a good reason why I didn't fall asleep this one night. So I was trying to remember all the things I've done wrong over the years, for 4 or 5 years. But not just from here in the school, but also at Uplands. But especially, I thought about the times where I've been getting into detention and getting into trouble. So I was starting to feel emotional because I thought to myself, I whispered this into my own mind before I went to sleep, which was, the next morning when I come to school, I'm going to apologize to all my friends that I've known for a very long time, and however long I've met these guys. So I went to sleep, and then the next morning I came here. I walked around everywhere. I was feeling emotional, especially, and I tried to make an apology to all these people. And then, true enough, once my life changed completely, all my friends in high school started to become such amazing friends to me, just like now. If I was gonna, like say later today, if I was gonna hang around at lunchtime, and people walk by me and notice me, they're just gonna come over to me and feel happy because of how much I changed the school a lot, or school spirit especially, that I'm gonna talk to you about in just a minute. So grade 12, the final year of high school for me, it was absolutely emotional. First of all, because of thinking of all the things I'd done in school that was awesome. And then during the 2016 high school award ceremony, I received something called a school spirit award that you guys might hear about in the award ceremony this year, maybe. And I won it last year. It was a huge step for me. Well, first of all, I also won the school spirit award in grade 11, but it wasn't that huge than how this one was, because I had 3 medals and 3 certificates for showing school spirit, leadership, and the commitment to the school and community. And I'm going to also, well, first, I might as well share 2 pictures. The one on the left was me when I was your age, grade 8. The other one is the picture of me in grade 12. Now, this is what's going to happen. When you're going to grade 12, you're going to wear a grad gown, dress good, and show your parents how excited you are to graduate. Well, I actually wasn't excited. I almost decided not to smile, but it turned out I needed to because of my friends, especially in for the yearbook. Now, if for those students that went to Rock City last year, you might remember this card, my grad card I got. It's interesting because Mrs. Attrell, who was there last year, gave me this big envelope one time back in June. And I was like, what in the world is this? So I opened the envelope, and true enough, I saw this big card. Then I opened it, and then this is what I got. So it says, then step into the future with confidence and always be proud of who you are. Congratulations, best wishes from Rock City Elementary. And it has all these names of students as well as the teachers and even the principal that was there last year. He's not there anymore though, Mr. Young. He's now Principal Allen Connected. He was probably the nicest principal I've met. One of the nicest principals though I've met. And yeah, he wrote in the card somewhere in there. And I just had to keep it. I just couldn't throw it away. It's probably the only good card I've liked in my graduation. So now I'm gonna show you something I call the big step. And there's a reason why I call it the big step. It's like I was saying to you a few minutes ago where I was talking about the 2016 School Spirit Award. Well, there's a double step to this. So you might remember Mr. Mason from last year when you were looking around the school. He was a vice principal for a few years. But also, he wasn't just a vice principal. He was a teacher and a coach for sports. And he's been at Wellington for 26 years and just retired last year. And they wanted to surprise him for something that we made an award called the Tom Mason Bobcat Award. And the reason why we wanted to do that for him was because he showed a lot to Wellington with pride and how much he really tried to care to setting up the school and for certain things, as well as coaching, sports, and as well as being a good leader. And they also wanted to have a grad student win that award and have my name on a plaque, which I'm going to show you right now. So this is what it's like. So it says Matthew Crossell 2015-16 on it, and Tall Mesa Wildcat Award, and it's out in the hallway actually. If you, when it comes to lunchtime, might as well take a look at right where all those medals and stuff are. You'll see the Tall Mesa Wildcat Award, and you'll see my name on there. But what really gets me curious is who's going to get the next one with their name on it. It always gets me curious because we don't know who. It's gonna be a grad student, a grade 12 student that's graduating, but it always makes me curious of who, because I don't know, unless if I find out from anywhere. So I'm gonna actually show you a video of when I won it, that award, so you guys can see what it was really like. It was really cool.
Which leads me to our final award for tonight. This is a new award presented for the first time in 2016. This award goes to a student who, much like Mr. Mason, represented the spirit of Wellington and went to the school of Wellington. We are awarding a graduate who succeeded in a number of ways in and out of the classroom, showed tremendous growth, leadership, school, and community spirit. Recipient for 2016 is displayed tremendous pride in Wellington, volunteered whenever asked, and often when not asked. Was welcoming and engaging to all of our students, no attention to age, grade, or social group. The student gave countless hours to all activities at the school, large and small. And until today, seemed happy with only a single t-shirt for Nike. The plaque to this award reads, awarded to a Wellington graduate for outstanding service, leadership, and commitment to school and community. And we're very proud of calling it the Tom Mason Wildcat. The recipient of the 2016 inaugural Tom Mason Wildcat Award is Matthew Preston. Doing a huge favor.
So now we're going to get into some questions. So is there anybody that has any questions at all? Any students, teachers? Yeah?
What was your favorite part of high school?
My favorite part of high school, I definitely liked PE a lot. I loved taking physical education, getting exercise, playing games, and having fun. And I was actually a sound tech here for a few years, so I got all this set up. That's also a good memory, too, I can remember. And I did the announcements, too, last year, like you would have heard earlier. Yeah, that was me on the announcements for the end. I think those were the only good memories I can think of for being here. But I'll never forget them, especially now. Yeah?
What was your favorite lunch?
Oh, favorite lunch? Oh, there's lots of good food, but I remember going to get pizza. Actually, on Tuesday, I ordered a whole pizza for myself, just to treat myself. I had to, because I said it on the announcements, Tuesday, I'm hungry for pizza, so I had to do it. I didn't want to lie, because I don't lie. But I ate it. Anyone else? Yeah?
Did you ever have the urge to order a pizza in your class?
Oh, no. No. We wouldn't be allowed to have food or drinks in class. It's a main policy. There are so many good teachers, actually, but the teacher I had the most in school was Mrs. Gertson, because I had her for PE 4 times in my school year, grades 8, 9, 11, and 12. And, of course, I got fitness and praise.
I was going to say, you better watch out, Matt. Wait here. Hello?
Yeah, well, I'll a little good memory with Ms. McCray, actually. I had her for math when I was in grade 8. Well, it's actually a grade 9 level, math. But every time not every time, but there was times where some of the students will be talking and not listen to what Ms. McCray is trying to say. So, and when we were trying to finish our review for a certain assignment we had to do, you'll have the moments where you're going to know what page we're doing and how many questions. But there was something funny that happened, which was, if you guys keep talking, I'm going to assign more questions. And she did.
That's right.
And I
don't think these guys are surprised by that one.
Yeah, well, that's something that you should keep in mind, too, is when you be quiet, there'll be something good for your science. Yeah, thank you. Yeah? Well, I would say be a good leader. Even when you guys get to grade 9, 10, 11, and 12, try to be a leader for the grades that come for the next few years. That's what I did. And it worked good. And actually, Mrs. Gertson told me that advice many times, so I know that advice really well. Thank you. Yeah?
How did you get to
grade
11?
Well, I used to have troubles with my disabilities I have. Like, I got diagnosed at 2.5 years old with autism. So I was just never used to being autistic until I was in high school. And I started presenting my autistic life for two years ago. So I went to different schools talking about my life, and it started to become a really good thing for me. So, I'm not nervous to present, like I'm not nervous today, but I'm very glad to also be back here to see the new people here, as well as the students I met in the last few years. Yeah, thank you. Yeah?
How is it different, like, you said when you think differently than some people do, how is it different?
Well, there's some things that I will, here, and there's something that other people would agree, but there's things I don't agree with. Like, I know a perfect example for that, actually. I've heard people before that say that drinking underage is a good thing, and it's not. It's mainly not, because it's illegal. And people don't believe it's illegal, so that's a big thing I can say. And because I get stripped from when I catch people saying that they're going to drink under 19. So that's a huge one there, I have to say. But when I, well, even later on in life, like say if I was going to get a new job, for example, in the future, there will be lots of things that I'm going to be taught, but there might be things that I need to know more about it again. It's happened. It's happened to me many times. Yeah. Thanks. Yeah.
Do you have any like tips or anything for people with autism? Because my brother actually has autism, not major but like minor. He doesn't have like any sort of filter or like anything. So do you have any tips to sort of how to deal with this?
Well, and also you can't tell. Most lot of people don't think I am autistic. A lot of people, because you can't notice it. People think I'm a regular person. And I know people have tried to, people have felt sorry for me because of how different I am from others. But you don't have to be, because I do feel like a normal person. I'm really not. But also, when for your brother, he can just try to make him succeed, no matter where he's at. Where he, how old is your youngest? Because pretty soon he's going to make a big step coming here to where high school, probably here, I guess, is that right? Yeah. So when he, so then for you, you can be a big leader for him when he comes to high school. So then you can show him around, tell him what it's like. So like I was saying earlier, be a leader to the school. That's exactly, that would exactly work. It would work perfectly. Yeah. That would probably be a good thing, I would say. Because he, remember, he might have trouble remembering so many things right away.
He's like the opposite. Like he is really good at like all the like math and science.
Oh really?
He's like such a smart kid, but he has like social trouble.
Yeah. Oh, so with friends.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some friends out there, they're just not right for people sometimes, and there's people that are okay with it. And I know there's some special groups sometimes where friends will get together and hang out. I was in that too before. And it did work out. So I made some more friends as well during that time. So maybe that might be something that might happen when your brother gets graded. Yeah. Yeah.
Hi, Matt.
Yes.
You touched on bullying when you were in elementary school. And I just wanted to say, I think you're amazingly normal. And could you touch on bullying now and your beliefs about bullying today?
I absolutely believe bullying is a bad thing. I've believed that for a very long time, and I just never wanted to see it, especially even when I was when I'm here visiting. I just don't want to catch it even at lunchtime. So I've seen it many times, even in grade 12. I've stopped people many times for crazy stuff, fighting. I've seen it, and I've caught it, and I'm not trying to be just like, you know, well, I can kind of be like a vice principal, but not really, but I'm just trying to give them good advice to make them improve better.
Being a good leader?
Exactly.
You're a good leader, man.
Yeah. And I believe that too when I won the Tom Mason Walk Award, surprisingly. And I think that was the main reason why I expected standing ovation when you saw me up on the stage and people were standing up. I didn't even expect a standing ovation, just to be honest. I didn't expect that, but it turned out it did. And I figured I knew it for kind of a good reason, because of that. Being a good leader and also being supportive of Wellington, like I would still do it too. Even cheering for the Wellington teams, the Wildcats. The Wildcats rule. They do. Yeah. Anyone else? No? Just before I finish, I just want to share with you guys my website, www.mmcrassel.wix.com.
were back at Wellington. It's still emotional times, still, and was very hard for me to leave that place again. It still always has been. The speeches went really well. I was really glad to get over there to speak in front of the new students that were recently started to attend there. I did 6 speeches. It was really good for 6 different classes. And that's a good way to finish off the 2016-2017 year, is to go back to Wellington to do my presentation there. So now I won't be doing any more until presentations in schools until sometime next school year. I'm really hoping to do a lot more next school year, but let's hope. Let's hope for the better. And I remember talking to people before and after my presentations, even those people that were over grade 8, like grade 9, grade 10 students. Just asking them how they've been over the last several months when I've been away from school. Disappointing, of course, because of how much I really enjoyed being at school, and now students are going to be leaving soon. It's not just the graduating students from this year, 2017, but also the students that are trying to transfer to a different school. It's heartbreaking for them to leave to a different school, but it is what it is. It's just emotional times. Not even when I was in the building, I felt emotional because my greatest moments in my life were at Wellington. But now I'm just back home now, just relaxing right now. I'm just kind of celebrating, enjoying how things went. I really hope you guys all have enjoyed my presentations that you've watched today for all these 6 classes, and I hope you guys all take it easy, and I hope to see you guys all around, and hope to do more music stuff and presentations very soon. Take it easy.